are here to present to you a project on the production of constructional materials using nylon, plastic, and rubber waste. Nylon, plastic, and rubber has always been a global challenge when it comes to recycling. Nylon, unlike plastic, has proved to be impossible to recycle due to its non-biodegradable nature. In more developed countries, they found a way to recycle rubber and plastic, leaving the underdeveloped and developing countries with waste materials. Even though the developed countries still haven't found a way to recycle nylon, which is a global issue because it causes harm to the environment. Problems caused by nylon, plastic, and rubber include flooding and greenhouse effects. We have tried to come up with a solution for that, which is transforming these environmentally dangerous, non-biodegradable petrochemicals into constructional materials such as concrete material and particle board. Method of production. Mixing materials are nylon, plastic, and rubber from a waste bin, cement from a local cement vendor, water from a borehole, mixing materials and mold from a building material market, sawdust from a sawmill, top bun from a local market. Nylon, plastic, and rubber was transformed into gravel, sharp sand, and stone-like material called nitlaru. Nitlaru was made by burning nylon, plastic, and rubber with fire at a very high temperature, allowing it to cool, after which it was crushed with a hammer mill into 5 to 15 millimeter and powdered form. Production of constructional concrete material. The first interlock was made with 60% 5 to 15 millimeter of nitlaru, 40% cement, and hot water called C1. The second interlock was made with 30% 5 to 15 millimeter of nitlaru, 30% powder size, 40% cement, and cold water called C2. The third, fourth, fifth, and sixth interlock was made with 50% powdered nitlaru, 50% cement, and optimum temperature water known as C3. With the sixth interlock identified as C3I. The concrete floor was made with 30% 5 to 15 millimeter of nitlaru, 30% powdered nitlaru, 40% cement, and optimum temperature water called C4. The particle board was made with 70% sawdust, 30% 5 to 15 centimeter of nitlaru, and top bond. Going straight into the practicals, and these are our materials. This is the burnt nitlaru. This is the 5 to 15 centimeter of nitlaru. This is our optimum temperature water. This is the top bond. Producing C3 now. This is our 50% cement. Our 50% powdered nitlaru. Adding optimum temperature water. She's putting it into a mold. Observing air content tests by applying pressure. Now we're going to let it cure and set for about 9 to 10 hours. That's all for the concrete. We're now going into the production of particle board. So we have our 70% sawdust, and we're going to add 30% 5 to 15 millimeter of nitlaru. We're now going to add the top bond. bond serves as a resin agent. Add more top bond if it's not enough. This is a particle board mold. We're going to slap into a triangular shape and drop it on top of a wooden board. After that, we're going to add our mixture into the mold. After 18 hours, this will be the final product of the particle board. The tests done on the particle board were mechanical testing and water absorption and thickness swelling. Conclusion: nylon, plastic, and rubber were successfully substituted for gravel, stone, stone dust, and sharp sand in the production of constructional concrete materials such as interlock blocks, concrete floor, and road construction, etc., and in the production of particle boards. However, this provides a better and more sustainable recycling solution for nylon, plastic, and rubber. Thank you for watching, and we wish to see you next time.